Well, just four more days until Minnesota's primary election, and today Secretary of State Steve Simon made a stop in Hastings to demonstrate how local election offices test their ballot counting machines before each contest. Next Tuesday will be your opportunity to decide which names land on the general election ballot in November.
John Croman has more on how the primaries work.
In Hastings, the test of the Dakota County ballot tabulators went off without a hitch on this Friday afternoon.
We've had our independent election judges verify the totals and verify the tapes, and everything matches.
Secretary of State Steve Simon used the event to remind voters there is a primary election on Tuesday, a chance to set the stage for November's big event.
It's completely untraceable. No one knows whether a particular voter voted on the D side or the R side. Nobody knows.
There's only one ballot, with the GOP races on the left side and DFL races on the right. You can't cross vote. You have to pick a party and go with it.
So you can't vote for one candidate in one contest in one party and say for a different office, I want to vote for a Republican party candidate in another office. You can't do that. You got to stay in your lane.
The key statewide race to watch is the GOP primary between Republican endorsed candidate Royce White and Navy veteran Joe Fraser. In the Metro, the rematch between Congresswoman Ilhan Omar and Don Samuels in the 5th District is being closely watched. And in Western Minnesota, 7th District Congresswoman Michelle Fischbach is being challenged from the right by business owner Steve Boyd.
Now, for much of Minnesota's history, the primary was in September, but lawmakers moved it up to August to give service people overseas, and other overseas voters and members of the military more time to request absentee ballots and mail them back. And by the way, if you do accidentally cross vote, the machine should kick it out and you should get a different ballot. Back to you.